ஸ்ரீ கிருஷ்ணா ஸ்ரீ கிருஷ்ணா ஸ்ரீ கிருஷ்ணா ஸ்ரீ கிருஷ்ணா. குருர் பிரம்மா குருர் விஷ்ணு குருர் தேவோ மகேஸ்வர, குரு சாட்சாத் பரம் பிரம்ம, தஸ்மை ஸ்ரீ குருவே நமஹ, தஸ்மை ஸ்ரீ குருவே நமஹ. வில் ரீட் ஸ்லோக் நம்பர் 14. நித்யோஹம் நிர்விகல்போஹம் நிராகாரோஹம் அவ்யயஹ சச்சிதானந்த ரூபோஹம் பஞ்சகோஷாதிகோஸ்மிஹம் அகர்த்தாஹம் அபோக்த்தாஹம் அசங்க பரமேஸ்வரஹ சதா மத் சந்நிதானேன சேஷ்டதே சர்வமிந்திரியம் ஆதி மத்யாந்த முக்தோஹம் நபத்தோஹம் கதாச்சன ஸ்வபாவ நிர்மல சுத்தஹ ச ஏவாஹம் ந சம்சயஹ. ஆதி மத்யாந்த முக்தோஹம், முக்தா ஃப்ரீ ஃப்ரம், ஆதி பிகினிங், மத்யா த சென்டர் அண்ட் அந்த த எண்ட். ஐ எம் ஃப்ரீ ஃப்ரம் தீஸ் த்ரீ ஃபேக்டர்ஸ், பிகினிங், மிடில் அண்ட் எண்ட். Now this is what we have to experience. I have no beginning, I have no middle or the center, or I have no end. Now is it true or it is just only words? So we start reflecting. Please remember, Vedantic sadhana is not mechanical. In yoga it is mechanical. Get up early in the morning, do Surya Namaskar. Before going to bed, do Chandra Namaskar. In devotion, take tabla peti, start Hari Ram, Hari Ram. In Karma Kanda, start doing the same thing mechanically. In Upasana, take out all the gods, give them wash and put them back mechanically. And whenever anything is done mechanically, the charm of life goes away. And if the charm of life goes away, you are not a spiritual seeker. Then you are depressed. It is something like this. One or two examples I'll give you. What is the meaning of mechanical living? I was in Goa and taken to some big factory where they were manufacturing the steel files. Files, you know, they are used for smoothening the rough surfaces of the steel filing. Like the ladies have the nail files, because the nails are also as sharp as the steel. Shurpa nakha, see? Shurpa nakha is a nail. So, huge factory, there are a number of lathes or small machines. Maybe a few hundred. And each machine was attended by one person. And there were many these assembly belt kind of belts. And one piece will come, this person has got only one job, take it, put it, tuck, go, next one like that. And they are doing it for years together. So one day when I was there, I asked the host, I said, may I talk to somebody? Is it okay? He said, yes, you talk. So I asked one person, hey, if I talk to you, your work will be disturbed. He said, no, even without looking at it, I can do it. I am doing it for last 35 years. Like that typist. They don't have to look, where is K, kaha gaya? No, they do it mechanically. So I had no problem. Then I asked him, you are doing it for so many years. Do you enjoy it? He started laughing. Enjoy? What is there to enjoy? I said, why do you do it? He said, will you give me free food? So he was doing it without joy. Exactly the same thing happens in your so-called upasana spiritual practice. Anything you do mechanically, initially we have a great enthusiasm. Slowly things start getting away. Get up in the morning, the same God says, "Yaar, kab tak tumhara chehra dekhu?" It becomes mechanical. And when it becomes mechanical, the charm of life gone. Therefore, those who are doing meditation as a mechanical drill, they themselves are suffering and they don't like others who are enjoying. See, a person who doesn't get sleep, when he sees the next person to him or her sleeping, becomes more angry. Mujhe neend nahi aati, ye so hi ja rahe. See, because the charm has gone. See, friends. Therefore, here, Adimatyanta Muktoham, every meditation is new, fresh, and never repeated. And this is possible if every day we discover at least one new approach to the reality. Every day. So here is one example. How we can do this? See? So spiritual life is not a mechanical thing. I was reading one bhajan just before coming. That bhajan is written by Brahmananda Swami. And he writes in that bhajan that he who has discovered the God in his own heart, why will he go to the temples and disturb others? He who has no problem of his mind, why will he struggle for the meditation? He who has nothing to achieve in this world, why will he try to go and propitiate gods? Meaning, all these efforts end. Spiritual experience is spontaneity in expression. There is no preparedness. Like, you know, most of the people, they prepare their lecture. I had to talk on this mantra. So, and time is given half an hour and they are prepared. But what happens? Their prepared lecture is over in 5 minutes. 25 minutes, know what to do. Because what they have prepared, they can think only in that particular frame. Frame, friends, frame-wise thinking is samsara. Go beyond the frames. So, Adi Madhyanta Muktoham. So, one word you have taken. Adi Madhyanta Muktoham. Now, take one by one. What I think myself to be aham. So, aham, we start from the body or with the relations. Aham, husband, aha, I am husband. So, adi, muktoham. Do I have the beginning as a husband? Of course. That day of accident, yes, that was the day. One place I went, husband and wife, after 15 years of their marriage. And they said, Swamiji, we are constantly fighting. What should we do? I said, are you fighting only verbally? Yes. Take sticks in the hand. You must grow, you know. But why this is happening? I asked them, which is your anniversary? They said, 15 years. Therefore, as husband and wife, you are teenagers. As man and woman, you are grown up. But as husband and wife, you are teenagers. And teenagers never understand anybody. And therefore, both being teenagers, neither the husband understand the wife understand the husband. And that is why it is very much emphasized after marriage, immediately have a child. That alone will keep you together. Because then you will have a common enemy. See, terrorists unite us, the politicians divide us. So the child in the family, he is a terrorist. And then the child will start teaching the parents. One couple I know, they got a child very late. And their way of, what the husband's way of talking is very loud. He doesn't mean fighting, but that is how he talks. So his son tells, "Dad, when will you learn to talk decent to your wife? Why don't you talk slow? You are always in a fighting mode." So the father keeps quiet. "I am sorry." He said, "You always say sorry. Again you start." See, friends. Therefore, when you are living together, husband and wife, you become mechanical. And in that mechanical life, they say, like, you know, then we become addicted to the fighting. Like we know, eating pan, eating tobacco, smoking is bad. But once the habit comes, then you can't stop it. In the same manner, then tutu, my, tutu begins and the life is miserable. The same thing happens in your spiritual practice. Do not allow your spiritual practice to be mechanical. Every day take one word, for example, Adi Madhyanta Muktoham Aham, who is this I, husband? Is this husband free from the beginning, middle and end? No. Because he who is born as a husband, he will definitely change. He will become a father. You know, it is said before marriage, a man should fulfill his desire for having different clothes. After marriage, that department is taken over by the wife. Then, before the children are born, fulfill your desire of enjoying food. After the children are born, then whatever they want, that only you take what is left over from their plate. This is the choice. So there is beginning, there is modification, change, and there is also end. So I cannot be husband. Like this, go on working. Then I cannot be body. I cannot be mind. Because mind becomes manifest, remains, disappears. Becomes manifest, remains, disappears. In this manner, we come to a point that we do not have the experience of our birth, meaning Adi, beginning, the experience of modification, and also the experience of death, and therefore we don't have the experience of our absence. So Adi Madhyanta Muktoham. Everything drops in a fraction of moment. Adi Madhyanta Muktoham Na Baddhoham. I am not bound by any limitation. See, friends, I am bound is only an imagination. Like, you know, we imagine that without a particular thing, I cannot survive. You must have seen, you know, in some places, old husband and wife, one of them dies. Suppose the husband dies. Then don't look at the dead body of the husband. Look at this lady, what she is talking. Without him, I cannot live. Without him, I cannot live. And after the body is disposed of, everybody is waiting. Now she cannot live when she is going to die. But she doesn't die. Continues batting. See? So without him, I cannot live is just a bluff. Nothing is required for our existence other than our own being. We are not bound by anything. For this, conduct experiment the other day I told you on yourself. Decide, next 1 month I am not going to eat sweets. Don't tell anybody. The moment you decide, that day onward, all the sweets will start coming to your house. And then, yes, I decided, but not from this month, next month. See? Work on yourself. Similarly, do these experiments. And when these experiments you do, then you are working on your mind. One example I'll give you. I was in Arunachal Pradesh many, many years before. And I had that funny wrong notion that I don't care for food, I can take any food happily. Everybody has wrong notion. And in one school I had to stay for about a week. So the teachers told me, Swamiji, we have made your arrangement separately for you, food, etc. I said, no, I will take food with the children. Swamiji, you will not be able to take, it is not possible for you to eat. I said, no, what do you think of me? And then the children used to sit on the floor, I used to sit with them. Breakfast khichdi, lunch khichdi, dinner khichdi. And what is khichdi? Khichdi ke char yaar. Papad, mirchi, nimbu, achar. There were neither papad, nor nimbu, nor mirchi, nor achar. Only that khichdi, breakfast, lunch, khichdi. I started dreaming khichdi only. Difficult to eat. That day I discovered how much wrong notions we have about ourselves. See, friends. Therefore, when you start doing this experiment, then we come to know where we are caught up in life. Then get out of it. Na baddhoham kadachana swabhava nirmalaha shuddhaha. Essentially, we are not polluted. We are not impure. And it is our natural state. What is impurity? First of all, let us understand. Then we can understand purity. Like if you take this sweater, it has got a peach color. Now if there is some kind of one black or yellow, any spot, even very small, it will be seen as something impure. Because other than this one color, if something else is there, it is impure. In the same manner, while taking food, many times it happens, the food goes into my beard. And then some children, if they are, Swamiji, there is something rubbish in your beard. I say, okay, remove slowly, don't pluck. So that girl removes that small piece, grain of ice. See. Is the grain of ice a rubbish? That means what I am eating is rubbish or what? No, Swamiji, you don't understand. And when I am taking food, one beard hair was sacrificed. And it has fallen in the plate. Oh, don't eat that. See, there is something dirty. Do you think that there is a dirt on my face? So rice in the rice plate and hair in the beard are pure things. Other than that, whatever else is impurity. Now apply this principle. See, I am man, pure. Husband, impure. Father, super impure. Father-in-law, most miserable. Son-in-law, happy. See? Because all the son-in-laws are respected by the mother-in-law only as a sympathy. It's not love or respect. Don't get carried away. Ki my mother-in-law is better than my mother. No. It is a sympathetic look. Vichara aagaya. Narayana. See, friends. So, purity, man. All other thing is impurity. Now, this impurity find out. Is it real? See, So none of these relational positions in life, they are our essential nature. If you even simply reflect on this one theme, you will change your whole life. That all those who are miserable, they are non-existing entities. Mother, father, brother, sister, mother-in-law, father-in-law, daughter-in-law, grandfather, grandmother, grandson, they have no existence. They are just like the actors on the stage. See, suppose the son has been a very good boy and he is coming in always in the merit class, did very good in business. So the father says, yes, he is my son. And if the same son happens to be a terrible rascal and a terrible monster, then like a Hindi movie, Tu mere liye mar gaya, main tere liye mar gaya. And there is a step there. They go and walk. How can it happen? See. Therefore, Swabhava Nirmalaha. Essentially, we are neither bound nor having any impurity. Therefore, be attentive. Don't curse. Don't curse yourself for anything that has happened in your life in the past, knowingly, unknowingly, intentionally, or without intention. Anything that has happened, drop that. You are not that. Like with your childhood body gone, you are no more a child. In the same manner, any good or bad thing you have done in the past, it is gone. Don't carry that burden on your head. You are divine, friends. But we keep on, I don't know, why did I do like that? You know, no, I am regretting. The regret is that you are not able to drop it. About the past, there is only one thing we can do. Past is to be forgotten. And this is a gift given to us by God, the ability to forget. Take money from the people and forget. Then you will be remembered by the whole world. So if you want to be remembered after your death, try this. Take money from the known people. Maloom hai, kya kare? You'll be remembered. So that what is to be remembered, that we forget. That what is to be forgotten, that we remember. And that burden we carry in our life. Therefore, Swabhava Nirmalaha Shuddhaha. And this is what is called a Vishuddha Chakra, or the element space, which is the first creation in the sequence of creativity. Be attentive. When we are at the Muladhara Chakra, we are identified with the body. As a result, Swadhisthan Chakra, another catch, desires. As a result, Manipur Chakra, greed. When we are living at the lower three chakras, we are samsari. And the seeker is born. When he is no more interested in the lower three, now he has come to the Anahata Chakra. Now he starts working on the mind. Okay, this point, very important point. Physically, we go to office or we do our business by our body so that we can get our bread and butter. This is working by the body. Then we go to the gym, we go for running, we go for jogging. That is working on the body. See the difference? One is working by the body. Second is working on the body. Now what we have done to work on the mind? Nothing. We are only working by the mind. Working by the mind is complaints, comparisons, condemnation, evaluation, suggestions, taking decisions for others. See, labeling. This is working by the mind. So all our default expressions in life, that is working by the mind. Spiritual practice begins. That beginning is called as the birth of a seeker. One person asked me somewhere, Swamiji, in other country, Swamiji, are you a believer? I said, no. You are not a believer? I said, no. Do you mean Hindus are not believers? I said, no, Hindus are not believers. Then they are the seekers. There's a difference. Believers don't seek. When you start seeking, you start working on the mind. And what is working on the mind? Knowing what is happening in the mind. Mind has two sheds of thoughts. One thought is the subjective, technically called as aham vritti. The second is objective, technically called as idam vritti. So, the aham vritti is one, and idam, the not I, are many. Like, I know her, I know her, I know him, I know him. So, they are many, but I who is knowing all of them is one. Be attentive. Whatever may be the number of not I's, the I continues to be one. Now, if the number of not I maintained a huge number of not I, the I becomes very strong and very fat. And as we start reducing the entertainment of the not I's in our life, no more too many people, relations, no more too many possessions. So when the possessions and relations are reduced to a great extent, to that extent, this I thought becomes thinner and thinner. Be attentive. And when, as in deep sleep it happens, and when the not I thoughts have reached a stage of zero, then this I thought drops the thought aspect and a thought free I remains. This thought free I is migration from this Anahata chakra to the Vishuddha chakra. The Vishuddha chakra is what is said here, Svabhava Nirmalaha Shuddha Sa Evaham Na Samshayaha. That is what is the real meaning of aham, and I have no doubt whatsoever about it. Consciousness is knowledge, mind is knowledge. That knowledge where objectivity is predominant, that is mind. And that knowledge where objectivity is absent, that objectless awareness is the conscious reality. And all the objects are entertained only through the mind. Therefore, what we saw in the morning, yama, niyama, asana, pranayama, and pratyahar, these five things are meant for taking care of the external world. It is not allowed to enter our system. After that, now we start working on the mind. Dharana, dhyan, samadhi. Now the mind is not allowed to run any place, any theme, or for any time. Mind is as if stopped. When the mind stops, no movement, the truth is reached. Svabhava nirmala shuddha sa eva aham na samshayaha. In this, you don't have to believe. This is your essential nature. one youngster, he used to come sometime with his mother, and he drop his mother and go, never come in the temple. So his mother told him, Swamiji, you tell him he doesn't believe in God. So that boy said, he says, Swamiji, I don't believe in God, why should I go to temple? I said, come nearer me. He came, and in his ear I told, I also don't believe in God. Really? I said, no, I don't believe in God. Then I asked him, do you believe that you are, or do you know that you are? Belief is required in the field of ignorance. You already know God, why should you believe? But your mother is ignorant, you know. Therefore, she has to believe. And therefore, she is so ignorant, God is only in the temple. And you are so intelligent that God is everywhere except in the temple. He says, Swamiji, you are pulling my leg. I said, thank God you understood something. See, friends, therefore, seek. And seeking begins when you start working on your mind. If we can mind our mind, we have taken a big leap on the spiritual path. The mind is getting disgusting, all imagination, hallucinations. I was sitting, I saw God. Then God went. Then I am frustrated. Why God went? By looking at you, he got frustrated also. God also got frustrated. Understand, these are all the mental hallucinations. Remember one thumb rule. Anything which comes and goes is the flicker of mind. Mind has to be dissolved. Otherwise we get carried away by this thing that we go to Mahatmas, they have got many Siddhis. And we get very much influenced by them. You know, I went to that Mahatmaji, I had a back pain, and he simply gave one and gave me some bad abuse. Gadhe bhag yahan se. And after that, my back pain is gone. Swamiji, why this happens? Because you have realized you are gadha. Don't get carried away by these. These things do happen. Yoga Shastra very clearly tells, these things do happen, but that is not the truth. See, like the worldly things, name, fame, achievement, etc. They do happen, but they are not real. In the same manner, in the inner world, these are called as the play of Maya. See, friends, and once we get into this mode of various kinds of siddhis and all kinds of things, see what happens. You go to the such Mahatmas, the people around them, they are always living in a fearful complex. Don't do anything, Mahatmaji may scold you, something will happen, keep quiet, keep quiet. All the time leading in a fearful existence. See. And you have read the books also, there also, such and such Mahatma, he did this thing, therefore he became angry and he cursed him. Wherever there is cursing and blessing, you are in samsara. See, friends, therefore the truth is not for the dropouts of life. Many people have got that funny notion. Those who cannot practice this path of inquiry, they go into that bhavana. All the time, you know, God realization, going away from all the responsibilities. Why? I am mad after God. No, first part is right, not the second part. See? Therefore, muktoham. Now, continuing the further thought in the 17th mantra. ब्रह्मैवाहं न संसारी मुक्तोऽहमिति भावये अशक्नुवन् भावयन्स्तु वाक्यमेतत् सदाभ्यसेत्. Now these are the different stages for the different quality of students. One person asked, why you have got so many gods, so many paths? See ours, one god, one path, one day and one realization. I said, it is something like this. We have teach one uniform for all the ranks in the military, one size. Get one new recruit, put into him, into that uniform. If he is longer than the uniform, cut him. Next. Put another one. If that uniform is longer for him, pull him and bring him out of the uniform. Is that the way? See, friends, depending upon the quality of the student, the various approaches to the reality are told. It is not everybody, same thing. See, friends, therefore, here different approaches are told. First, Brahmaivaham na samsari, he who is able to live in this knowledge, he doesn't have to struggle for anything. Bhagavan Shankara's words, Yogaratova, Bhogaratova, Sangaratova, Sangavihira. He is beyond all the limitations of do's and don'ts. Because he has no doubt whatsoever. And he doesn't want to prove anything to anybody. Be attentive. One of the biggest obstacles for the seekers of truth is this. We try to prove something to somebody. Alas, we do not know what we want to prove and to whom and who cares for us. Don't try to prove. In that effort to prove something, you go away from the path that you have taken. This story I told some of my talks is not a story, real happening. When I reached London after traveling 8-9 hours, from there I had to go another 3-4 hours by car. So one British lady, she was taking me. I told her, I said, Baba, you are going wrong way, I think. Namiji, I have been driving here for 35 years. I said, that doesn't prevent you from making mistakes. Mistakes happen when we take things for granted. And after about 1 hour of driving, he says, Samiji, what you said is right. I have taken a wrong exit. What should I do? I said, follow Indian technique. Go wrong way. He said, no, we can't. I said, then suffer. So we have to go another 40 miles to take a U-turn. And by the time we reached that church where I was having my lecture on Gita, we were late by 1 hour. So I was thinking all people must have gone. Britishers are very time conscious. So I can enjoy my food and forget about it. But they were all sitting there. So I had no choice. So I finished my lecture, everything, socializing, tea, coffee. Then I had my dinner. And then I was watching one documentary on Tibet in my hostess house. So this lady who got me, she asked, Swamiji, are you not tired? Go and take rest. I said, it's none of your business. You go and take rest. Don't dictate me. I know what I have to do. No, I am not telling you that way, Swamiji, but you must be tired. I said, do you think I am tired? I am fresh. Actually, this is what I want to ask you. I want to be like you. What is the secret? I said, you cannot be like me. The reason? No beard. Longer the beard, more the wisdom. Shorter the beard, doubtful is the wisdom. Now go further. Then I told her, I said, Mama, your whole life is a struggle. to prove something to somebody. This is what you have been doing all your life. See, don't try to prove anything to anybody in this world. Be yourself, relax. Now what people will say? Kuch toh logo kahenge. Don't get carried away by the world. You will see most of us are miserable on this platform. What people will say? When you know the marriages between the different communities happen, you see that, you know, the parents of the girl or parents of the boys, you see their dialogue. Swamiji, we don't mind, but what people will say? Nobody is interested in you or your daughter's marriage, okay? You only imagine what people will say. They have got better things to do than look at you. We want to prove to the society we are very orthodox. We have never taken anything wrong in our house. And the son of that same family goes and gets married to a madam. And then his mother and father are completely paralyzed. In Dehradun it happened. I was staying in somebody's house. They had only one son who had gone to England for doing his CA. Right from morning onward, his name was Ashok. Ashokayan will start, like Ramayan. Mamaji, our Ashok is like Ashok. Continuously, I was, you know, saturated with Ashok. Third or fourth day, they were not there for breakfast. So I asked the servant, hey, what happened? Maharaji, they told that you let Maharaji take breakfast. I said, okay. I took. Lunch, they were not there. Dinner, they were not there. Then I asked the servant, I said, hey, something wrong or what? No, Maharaji, they told, they'll talk to you. I said, all right. Next day, breakfast time, they came, eyes red and face without makeup. The originality came out. You know, makeup is only to cover the breakup, nothing else. So, I didn't ask anything. Swamiji, and the lady started crying. So I kept quiet. When somebody cries, you should not do anything. Let them allow you, know, clean yourself. Then the husband said, cool, cool. Now we can't do anything. Be cool. Then she again said, Swamiji, we are telling you about our Ashok. You know, we have got his phone. And again started crying. So, at least it was good. We got his phone, that means he's still alive. You know, he went from here and now he phoned, we are coming back. Went third person, first person singular and coming now plural. And he said further, we'll again get married according to Hindu tradition. That means that girl is a madam. And then he says, I have decided to settle here in UK. Now tell me, Swamiji, this whole house, this whole property, everything we have kept for him. Now tell me what to do. I said, Amma, I have been calling you mother so many times. You hand over the property to me and relax. See, don't struggle to prove anything to anybody in this world. Take care of yourself. See? Then alone, these words become meaningful. Brahmaivaham na samsari. You know, one person gave me this definition of samsari. One young, healthy, educated, intelligent boy, one day unnecessarily thought, let me catch hold of samsari. He caught hold of and became a samsari. He's a samsari. And thereafter, other than misery, there is nothing in life. So, Brahmai Vaham na samsari, then Muktoham. Then who am I? I am Mukta, I am not bound. Iti Bhavayet. Now this is the second stage. First is knowledge. Straight away through inquiry. If you are not able to do that, then do this Bhavana. See? Bhagavad Gita says, Yoya Shraddha Saeva Saha. Change this Shraddha of yours. Today we are the Shraddha, then I am so and so. One example will make it clear. There was one boy, I was staying in a Gujarati house in Kerala. And one small little boy, you know, he is a married person. He was that time maybe 5 years, 6 years. So when we were taking breakfast, I asked him, "Hey Gujju, what's your name?" "Swamiji, I am not a Gujju." "All right, then who are you?" "I am Lohana Kachchi." Then I asked him, "Can you tie down your own Kachchi or mummy is to require?" "No." "I don't know." "So what is Kachchi?" "I don't know." "What is Lohana?" "I don't know." "Who are you?" "Lohana Kachchi." See friends, this is only bhavana. Now if we have to do this bhavana, why do we do this bhavana? "I am most unfortunate, you know, other people get such nice husbands and I get only one dumb, you know why?" It's only bhavana, nothing else. See friends, if you have to do the bhavana, do this bhavana. Aham na samsari mukto ham. See friends, the grass on the other side of the fence is always green. There is nothing like a good husband and intelligent wife in this world. These are illusions. See, if the wife is intelligent, she will never get married to that dumb fellow. See, therefore, don't get carried away by these. It's only the bhavana. We only do the bhavana that, "Oh, God is coming," and that happens. In the same manner, here the teacher says, "Ashaknuman bhavayanstu," the third stage. So do this bhavana again and again. Remind yourself, not publicly in front of somebody, but within yourself, that "I cannot be miserable. I am cheerful. I am happy. I am not miserable." Insist you are not miserable. Everything will change. And if that also you are not able to do, the third option is given. Like Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavan Krishna gives four options. Mayyeva mana adasva mayi buddhim nimeshaya. Fix your mind and intellect in me. Atha etat ashaktosi. If you are not able to do this thing, then this is the second option. If that you are not able to do, the third option. That you are not able to do, the fourth option. Kuch to karo. Here also the teacher says, first, brahmai vaham na samsari, knowledge. If not able to do this, mukto hamiti bhavayet. Remind yourself that you are divine. You are not bound by anything. That also, if you are not able to do this, ashaknuvan bhavayanstu, then vakyam etat sada abhyaset. Then start doing this japa. Aham brahmasmi. Aham brahmasmi. Aham brahmasmi. Repeat. Insist. As we have been insisting. "I am unfortunate. I am most miserable. Other people are better. But why everything I don't do?" This is only by practice. So this wrong practice is nullified by the opposite practice. That's all. It is only by practice alone we are miserable. And so by practice alone we can become happy. See. And this practice goes so deep in our system. Nobody says that "I am a man" or "I am a woman," but we all live that knowledge. So if I had to tell, "I am going" in Hindi, so I will not say, "Main ja rahi hu," unless I am a Gujarati from Bombay. You know, in the Gujarati houses in Bombay, these Marathi ladies work. And those ladies talk the feminine language. "Mi yete," the Gujarati also says, "Swamiji, mi yete." "Are Ram, you are a man." See, so when we are talking, we use this gender as the criteria. We never do this japa. "I am a man, I am not a woman." In the same manner, here the teacher is telling again and again, go on repeating this. ब्रह्मास्मि अहम ब्रह्मास्मि। सो ब्रह्मैवाहं न संसारी मुक्तोऽहमिति भावयेत् अशक्नुवन् भावयस्तु वाक्यमेतत् सदा अभ्यसेत्। आई एम नॉट मिजरेबल, आई एम नॉट मिजरेबल, नो मिजरेबल, शट अप, यू आर नॉट, वर्क ऑन दिस, ऑल मिजरीज विल डिसअपीयर। कंटिन्यूइंग फर्दर, यदभ्यासेन तद्भावो भवेत् भ्रमरकीटवत अत्रापहाय संदेहम् अभ्यसेत् कृतनिश्चयः। यद् अभ्यासेन तद् भावो भवेत्, दिस इज द रूल, वॉट एवर यू थिंक दैट यू बिकम, इज अ सिंपल रूल। सो इफ वी हैव टू थिंक, व्हाई नॉट वी थिंक पॉजिटिवली दैट आई एम हैप्पी, देयर इज नथिंग रॉन्ग। दिस चेंज इन द रीजन इज पॉसिबल, इट इज समथिंग लाइक यू नो द कॉमन एग्जाम्पल, a glass which is filled with half with the milk. Now how one looks at it? A negative thinking person will see the empty part of the glass and suffer. The positive thinking person will gulp the whatever available milk and enjoy. See friends, in the same manner, don't look out for what you don't have. But that has become our habit. You must have seen your children for the first time when they lose their tooth. The mothers tell, don't bring your tongue there again and again like that, you know. Because the tooth will come out like a pig coming out, you know. Don't do like that. So, where the teeth are, there the tongue doesn't go. Where the tooth is not, there the tongue goes. In the same manner, what God has given us, that we don't talk. What He has not given us, that we keep on talking. Most disgraceful existence. Count the blessings, but that we forget. And then keep on condemning everything in this world. Therefore, again and again, remind yourself, you are not miserable. And those people who show that they are miserable, they are very strong ego. They are constantly seeking attention. You must have seen those who have got dogs in their house instead of gods. See, you go to their house, and if you don't pay attention to the dog will start barking and jumping on you. He wants attention, that's it. Only 2 minutes ago, pat him, hug him, give him your face to lick. They don't require D3 injections. It is given an oral dose. Those who cannot love human beings, they love dogs. So, they require constant attention. In the same manner, we require constant attention, and therefore we pretend to be so what happened? If you all come and do this thing, why will I do this? One lady came to me once many years before, and without telling, she is coming, suddenly dropping like the rains here. Then I said, hey, why did you come? You didn't tell me you are coming. Namini, I am very miserable. So I was taking my cup of tea. When I take cup of tea, that is my meditation. But that is the time people come and spoil it. So she came. Then I became very angry. She never seen my Narasimha Rao avatar. So I said, shut up, you are not miserable. So repeat what I say. And she started shivering. I said, sit down. He sat down. So repeat what I said. I said, say, I am happy. Swamiji, but. I said, did I say Swamiji, but? Only repeat what I said. He started in a very disgusting tone. I am happy. When her tone changed, I said, Mama, now simply keep quiet. Now tell me sincerely. Swear by anybody except me. Tell me, are you really miserable? No, that way. Then why did you say? You are not miserable. It's only to seek attention. All these miserable fellows are like that. They want sympathy from the world. They are having self-pity. This is exactly what Arjuna did in the first chapter. He was seeking sympathy from Bhagavan Krishna for his stupid thinking. And he wanted Bhagavan Krishna should agree with him. So in the later period of time, then, okay, I was wrong, but Bhagavan Krishna was there. Why did he not support me? See? Therefore, Bhagavan Krishna did not sympathize with him. He gave him left and right. These sympathy seekers are very strong egos. As we should not have pity on ourselves, don't have pity on others. If you can, help. If you can't, don't spoil your mind. See, friends. Therefore, yadabhyasena tadbhavo bhaved bhramara kitavat. They give this example. Like the egg becomes the pupa, pupa becomes the caterpillar, caterpillar becomes the butterfly. In the same manner, through stages, one can attain the highest in life. Only continuity of commitment to the cause. Friends, what we lack in life is intensity and urgency. Instead of intensity, we have got hurry. We are in a hurry. Swamiji, when will I get realized? People ask. So my question is, suppose you get realized, what next? Imagine you are realized, what next? Why roti belen ki abhi belo na? See, friends. Don't have this funny notion. Realization means something extraordinary will start happening to you. When you go all around you, there will be all the gods dancing. You know, nothing will happen. So, atra apahaya sandeham. Give up any doubt about this practice. Instead of simply chanting mechanically, and then the mantra goes so fast and so much abbreviated. All the gods get confused. Are you kisko bula raha ho? That is not the way. Don't be mechanically in anything that you do, including chanting Lord's name. More than how many times you have chanted, see how much time you are with God. See, tatra abhyasena, by this abhyasa, you will come to know, if you are properly doing your japa sadhana, then your vaikari vani will become quiet and purified. First, we do the japa. Sri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram, Sri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram. If the japa is properly done, Vaikhari Vani will become quiet and the Sri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram will descend in the Madhyama Vani. Then external chanting stops. Like when the fruit becomes mature on the tree, it detaches effortlessly. And when in the mind this japa is going on continuously, then that also stops. And the rasa of the Ramanam starts permeating in and through all the expressions of life. Rama Rasa. That rasa is not like the aam ras, mango ras. It is aam ras. It is not khas ras. Khas ras is ram ras. And when the ram ras happens, life is fulfilled. Na dhoka lena, na madhoko dena. Life is fulfilled. Therefore, atra apahaya sandeha. Give up any doubt about this spiritual practice of again and again reminding you that you are divine. See? The other day, one person asked me a question, Swamiji, with the problem, what should I do? I said, you know, when you have got problem, think of me. Your problem will disappear. After that was done, there was another person standing, Swamiji, how can you say like that? I said, why you are worried? That was my patient, it was not your patient. No, but I want to know. Normally, Babaji say, Bhagwan ka naam lo. I said, I am not a Babaji. Your problem is over. See? What is important is, when you say, think of God, can you think of God? You have not seen God. You are only hearing all kinds of things. But you have seen a person you can think about. And the moment you change your thinking line, all problems disappear. We are caught up in what you call thought fixation. Like, you know, in our Banaras, if you go, during that Shivratri, they have this bhang, PK bhang ka pyala. Suppose that time you were laughing and you take the bhang, you keep on laughing, the thought fixation happens. Suppose that time you are chanting the Lord's name, Om Namah Shivaya. You keep on chanting Lord's name. Thought fixation happens. Because bhang chad gaya. Exactly the same way. We are all bhang chad gaya. Aam dukhi, aam samsari, aam dukhi. Utaro isko. Asandeha. Don't have any doubt about this spiritual practice. Atra apahaya sandeham. Abhyaset krutanishchayaha. Kurtanishaya with firm commitment. Abhyaset. Nobody can do it for you. You must have seen many rich people. They engage the pujari to do the japa for them. It is something like telling the wife, honey, I don't like that quinine, terrible medicine. Will you please take it on my behalf? And that dumb honey will take also. But your disease will not go. In the same manner, we have to live our life, we have to die our death, we have to practice our spiritual practice. There is no proxy on that. This is a path by the one, to the one, all alone, without getting lost in the loneliness. This is the only way. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha Hari Om.